Hi, this is Michelle Peterson. We are filming here at Kiowa, outside of Sandcastle. This class is going to be tone and tighten. I'm not going to play music, so you, if you would like to put music on in your home, go ahead and start that. There's portions that you could use one light weight, but a weight isn't necessary. We're just going to go right into the lower body strengthening, so if your back isn't warmed up, you might want to do a little bit of stretching. Otherwise, if you're ready to go, we are just going to start with some squat, alternating cross crunches. So weight to the heels, stand it up, shoulder towards opposite knee. And if you don't like the squat, then do them as standing cross crunches. We're going to do all these moves for about 30 seconds. You can go at your pace. If you want to go faster than me, feel free. Last one. Good. Next one, we're going to come into a plie stance. Wide stance, heels in, toes out. We're just going to come up and down in some plies to start. Weight is in your heels. Sit it back. Feel like you're reaching for a chair back there. You decide how low you go. Next time down, hold it down, shoulders down and back, just some side bends. Keep those abs pulled in. Weight is in your heels. If you're uncomfortable down in that plie, just stand it up, do the side bend standing. Back to the middle, stand it up, shake those legs out. Next one, squat, alternating side leg lift. Feet hip distance, sit it back, arms come up, and you lift that leg out to the side. It's just a little lift, keeping that foot parallel to the floor. If you want to go deeper or faster, make it more cardio, feel free. Good job. All right, next one, we're going to do plie walks. There's also an option for hops. So we're going to stay down in our plie. We're going to take four walks forward and then four walks back. You're sitting it back the whole time. If you want to make these more intense, you're doing two hops forward and two hops back. So keep going in your way. Get intense, those abs pulled in. Last time back. And stand it up. Last one, you can use a light weight for this one. Water bottle, whatever you have. It's not necessary. We're going to do a static lunge with rotations. So right foot forward, left foot back, that back heel lifted. We're going to come down in our lunge, rotate one way. Back to the middle, stand it up, and then side two. The lunge does not have to be low, but you need to go straight down. Back knee is going straight towards the floor. Again, it doesn't have to be low. little more on this side. Bring it up, shake those legs out, and side two. Left foot forward, right foot back, heel lifted. Lunge it down, rotate to one side, and lift it up. Last one. Good job. Shake those legs out. You can keep your weight close. There's one other section where you can use it if you would like. But we're now going to come down to all fours and work that lower body. We're going to start in our quadruped. Hands directly under shoulders, knees directly under hips. We're going to bring our left leg out to the side, and we're going to flex our foot, and we're going to lift and lower from there. You're squeezing that side glute to lift it up. You may not get all the way up, that's perfectly fine. Try and keep the weight on your hands even. Keep it lifted. Now we're going to straight leg, sweep back to that opposite corner, and then sweep back out to the side. Leg is nice and long. Pulling those abs in to keep that torso stable. Trying to keep the weight on the hands even. Stay on that side, but just a little release. Now we're bringing that leg straight back, toe down, heel up, straight leg lifts and lowers. Squeeze that glute at the top. Two more. Next time, lift it, hold it straight out, little baby circles from the hip. Reach that leg. One full extension, circle the other way. Little release. Okay, now we're going to the last part. We're gonna do a little spider woman, knee to elbow. So you can choose if you wanna stay in this quadruped or you wanna be in a modified plank, bringing it in and out, or a full plank. All right, get to your position. We're opening that hip, elbow to knee, kick out and up. Keep going. We're gonna do 10 of these, and then we're gonna do little lifts at the end. At any point you need to come out of that modified or full plank, just come out. Next time out, hold it out, little lifts, up. Good job, bring it down. Everybody come to a child's pose. Release that back before we do side two. Okay, same thing, side two. So get lined up, hands directly under shoulders. Bring that right leg out to the side, foot flex, pull those abs in, lift and lower. Next time up, leg nice and long, sweep it to that back corner, point your toe in the back corner, then flex foot as you come forward to the side. One more, then hold that leg out there. Little tiny lifts, higher, higher. Good job, bring it down. Back to our child's pose or some cat's cows, something to stretch that back out. Okay, we're now gonna come to kneeling. We're gonna do a couple moves from here. So we're gonna start out with some side bends. You're gonna be kneeling, and you're gonna bring your left leg out to the side. Upper body is nice and upright, pull those abs in. We're gonna do 15 side bends towards this extended leg. Crunch it over, back to the midline or a little past. Keep pulling those abs in. Nice and upright, you're just leaning to the side. Two more. Good. Second part, we're gonna do either a side box or your type of side plank with rotation. So if you're doing a side box, if your shoulders don't like side planks, you can just lean to the opposite side, have those fingertips resting just to support you. We're gonna rotate under and up. If you'd prefer to come to a side plank, either modified or full, make sure that hand is directly under your shoulder. Keep it lifted. Rotate under. Rotate up. Keep breathing. Wherever you're at, if you're in the side box, it's fine. Just keep squeezing that lower oblique. You'll be working it. Last two. Good job. All right, we're gonna start with the side bends on side two. So everyone is back to kneeling. Now your right leg is out to the side. Nice long, pull your abs in. Upper body upright, crunch towards that extended leg, back to the midline, a little past. Those abs pulled in, you don't want to feel any twisting in your back. And make sure your upper body is nice and upright. floor. Good. Now come into either that side box with your fingertips down. You don't want to put weight on your shoulder, or coming out to a modified knee down or full stacked or split side plank. I'll do modified on this side. Rotate under, rotate up. Good job. Bring it down. We're going to come to seated for hinge hold and rush and twist. So this is one, if you want that one lightweight or water bottle, you can use it. We're going to do sweeps and you can pass that weight if you like. If you don't have a weight, it's not a big deal at all. All right, roll those shoulders down and back. Knees bent, heels on the floor. Lean back till you feel, we're doing hinge holds first. You're going to keep your abs engaged so your back is straight and strong. We're going to lean back and we're going to sweep one arm out to the side and back, lift it up, other side. So you lean as far back as you can that your abs can still get you up and you don't feel anything in your back. You want to keep those abs pulled in the whole time so your back is nice and strong and supported. Last one. Good. Bring it forward. Release your back. You can do a little seated happy baby here if you like. Now we're going to come back to a Russian twist. So whatever your weight is or your hands are fine, you're going to lean back, hold it back there. Slow and controlled, our hands side to side. If you need more intensity and you can stay stable, you can lift those heels off the floor, come into that boat position. And if you need even more intensity, you can straighten those legs and do these in a V-sit. One more each side. And release. A little butterfly. Relax your back, relax those abs. Good. We're gonna do a 1 minute plank. We're gonna do a plank with shoulder taps. So you can be in a modified plank or a full plank or stay in your quadruped. We're gonna bring arm to opposite shoulder, pulling those abs in, keep breathing. If it gets to be too much, in your full plank, come to the tops of your knees. If it's too much in your modified plank, then come to all fours. You are just trying to pull those abs in so you can remain completely stable. 15 more seconds. Last one, and bring it down, child's pose, release that back. Good job. We are now going to come to our backs, lying on our back. Our first move is going to be a Pilates move. We're going to do double leg stretch. So, upper body, relax on the mat, abs engaged, You're going to bring your legs into a tabletop to start. You can keep your head on the mat, or if you can hold an upper body crunch, you're going to lift your upper body up. Hands on the outsides of the calves. We're going to extend arms overhead as we extend those legs long. Sweep those arms around as you bring those legs back to a tabletop. You're going to decide how high or low those legs go. Want to keep that lower back in the mat. The higher you go, the easier it's going to be to keep that lower back down. If your head gets tired, just bring it down. One more. Good, relax that upper body, knees to chest, release everything. For our next one, we are going to do a one-sided partial or full sit-up. We're going to start right arm overhead, left leg long. You're going to decide where you want to have this right leg. You can have knee bent, foot on the floor. We're going to reach upper body up, lower body, lifting that leg towards the middle. You can use this other hand to help you. If you need more intensity, you're going to have that right leg extended and hovering somewhere, higher or lower. All right, long arm right side, long leg left. You're going to lift up to the middle and extend back down, nice and slow, one vertebra at a time. Once you get more engaged, you may be able to get up a little higher. Going. It can be a very small lift. The important part is controlling it down. Last one on that side. Little break between. Rest your neck. Knees to chest. Side two. Right leg extended. Left arm overhead. You decide where that left leg is going to be. We're going to bring arm and leg towards each other, control it down. This right hand can help you, or if you don't need it, don't use it. Rock around. We're going to do a one-legged glute bridge. Right knee bent, foot on the floor, right in front of your hip. We're going to lift our left leg to the ceiling. Squeeze that right glute all the way up and all the way down. Two more, and then we're going to keep that glute bridge lifted. Next time up, hold it up, long leg on the left, lower with control, and lift with control. The whole time you're squeezing that right glute to stay lifted. If you get tired, then just seat back to the mat. Keep going with the single leg lowers. Lift it, keep squeezing it, don't let it sag. Two more. Lower everything down, knees to chest, little break between. Then we'll do side two. Okay, line up that left foot directly in front of the hip, right leg straight to the ceiling. Squeeze that left glute all the way up, all the way down. Peterson. Two more like that. Next time up, hold it up. Nice long leg on the right, lower with control. Try and lift it all the way back up. Leg coming over that hip. Squeezing that left glute. One more. Bring it down, knees to chest, rock around, release everything. Next one, we're going to do ab scissors straight to flutters. So for these, you can have hands under your seat if you like to keep your lower back down. If you prefer to be in an upper body crunch, or you can just keep upper body on the mat. Legs nice and long. We're scissoring them down and up. They're crossing in somewhere in the middle. Breathing, keep reaching those legs long. More important to have good extension than how low you go. A few more, and then you're going to decide how high or low those legs are going to be. And then you're going to go into little tiny leg flutters. Reach them long. Knees to chest, relax everything. Last part of that, we're going to do a little ankle over ankle crisscrosses, working those inner thighs. So start with legs to the ceiling, as extended as you can get them. You can have hands under your seat. Heels in, toes out, as much as you can. Little, tiny, fast leg beats. Ankle over ankle. If you need more intensity, you're going to bring them lower to the floor. Keep breathing. And knees to chest, relax. Next one, we're going to do bicycle crunches. So you can decide if you want to have knees bent feet on the floor or if you want to do them from tabletop. Hands behind your head, gently press your head into your fingertips, keep those elbows wide, right shoulder towards the left knee, extend that right leg, nice and slow and controlled. Try to be stable in your torso. If you want to add more intensity to these, you can do a double crunch. A little more lift, a little more rotation on the second one. Otherwise, keep going with the singles. Chest again. We're just going to do some side-to-side leg lowers, so that upper body is relaxed, back of the shoulders on the mat. In tabletop, lower to one side, try to keep that other shoulder down, and then to the other side. You want to do these with straight legs, old windmills, do that as well. Last two. And knees to chest. Release one more time. We are going to come to our side and do a clamshell series. So you can stay down for these, or this first part, the regular clamshells, you can lift up to a side plank. You're going to have knees bent, legs stacked, your heels are in line with the back side of your body. If you're going to lift, make sure your elbow is under your shoulder, you're on your forearm. Squeeze those heels together. We're going to do 15 regular clamshells, opening that top leg. Lift. If you want to do the side plank, you can lift with it. Lift it up, control it down. Get tired of the side planks? Just do them with that hip down. Rotation. We're going to bring that knee to knee, circle the hip, heel to heel. So the thigh bone is rotating the hip in that hip socket. Together, the more you're going to feel that hip. Five more like this. Next time open, hold it open. Little pulses at that end range. Squeeze that side glute to open it. Good, and release it down. Next part, we're gonna work the lower leg, inner thigh. So you can either bring that top leg all the way over, you can have it in front or behind, wherever you're comfortable. Bottom leg nice and long, foot flex, squeeze that inner thigh, lift and lower. Legs are glued together, so you're right here for lower body. You're going to lift both sides, top arm is over, lift it up, control it down. Ten more of these. Last two, and release. Good job. All right, we are going to go to side two, starting with the regular clamshell. If you would like to lift to the side plank, make sure you have forearm on the mat, elbow right under the shoulder, stack those legs, your heels are in line with the back side of your body. Heels squeeze together, open that top knee, and close it. more. Good, lower it down. Now we're gonna make those semicircles. Knee to knee, open it up, heel to heel. Next time, keep it open. Little pulses at that end range. Squeeze that side glute. Good job. Lower it down. Now we're going to do bottom leg, so top leg over or behind. Reach that leg long. Foot flex. Squeeze that inner thigh to lift and lower. Before we stretch the quad. So come on down, glue those legs together. We're going to do both sides, arm overhead, lift and lower with control. Two more. Good, and let's bring that top leg heel to seat and stretch that quad. And release, we're gonna come to our stomach. We're gonna do some, you are gonna choose what kind of extension you're gonna do. So watch me first, because you're gonna have to be looking straight down at the mat to keep your neck neutral. Pull those abs in. You can do a baby cobra, legs long, abs engaged, a little lift and lower. You can lift higher, that's fine. Just keep pulling those abs in and looking straight down at that mat. Feel like you're doing it just with back strength. Even lift those hands up as you extend up. Last one, hands under shoulders, gently back to that child's pose. We're going to release that back in the child's pose. And from there, if you'd like to do some cats and cows, some further stretching, feel free. Stay in that child's pose, do some cats and cows. Thank you for joining me today, and have a good day.